When it comes to truly low profile CPU coolers, your options are a bit limited. Of course, you can stick with the stock cooler, but as anyone who's used an aftermarket cooler knows, stock coolers are pretty awful. Fortunately, Noctua has what might be the single best cooler for many ITX systems. Howdy, howdy guys, Ponchato here, and today we're taking a look at the NH-L9i super low profile CPU cooler from Noctua. Thanks to Noctua for sending this over for review, and let's get started. First, a bit of background. There are actually two nearly identical NH-L9 coolers, the L9a and the L9i. The A version is specifically for AMD sockets, including AM4, while the I version is for Intel's LGA 1151, and both cost around $40. However, Noctua did release an AM4 upgrade kit, which does allow the L9i to be used on AM4 systems, so the L9i is technically the more universally compatible cooler. First, we'll take a look at the packaging and what's inside. On the front, it has all the most important information: LGA 1151 socket compatibility, 37mm tall, and full RAM compatibility. The sides have more in-depth info like RPM ratings, dimensions, and info about the thermal paste. Looking inside the box, we have everything very neatly laid out. On top are the instructions for installation, which amount to a grand total of 4 steps, but Noctua does have nice illustrations here. Under that, the 4 thumb screws to mount the cooler to the motherboard. Next, we have the low noise adapter, which limits the fan's RPM in case your motherboard doesn't allow you to control it. On the other side, Noctua's NTH1 thermal paste, which does come in a big enough tube for multiple installations. A metal case badge is at the top if you're into that sort of thing. And finally, we have the cooler itself, which is surprisingly heavy for its size. Also in the box is a bag of 25mm fan screws if you want to replace the stock fan with one that's thicker and therefore more effective at cooling. On first inspection, the L9i is remarkably tiny. Its footprint is 95x95mm, only barely larger than the 92mm fan on top. And its total height, including the fan, is only 37mm. That's nearly 10mm shorter than the stock Intel cooler, and only barely taller than standard height RAM. That means this cooler can fit into pretty much any case out there. In addition to that, because its footprint is so small, it stays well away from the RAM slot, so RAM clearance is unlimited. This is a seriously tiny cooler. Noctua doesn't give it a specific TDP rating, but rather has recommendations based on the generation and model of processor you're using. Generally speaking, it can handle 65 watts, but in some cases they do increase that rating with proper ventilation. The heatsink itself is ridiculously small, only 23mm in height. Less than an inch. It has densely packed fins held in place by 2 heat pipes bent in a U-shape. The base is polished smooth and should allow for good contact with the CPU. The fan is where the L9i gets its magic. The 92mm NF-A9X14 fan is, as the name suggests, only 14mm tall. It uses Noctua's well-regarded SSO2 bearing and is rated for 600 to 2500 RPM, though with a low noise adapter cable can be limited to only 1800 RPM. Personally, I'm not a big fan of Noctua's color scheme, but at the very least I can say it is unique. And as we'll see in a bit, the fan is insanely quiet. The installation procedure is, like many aspects of this cooler, extremely well done. With your CPU in the socket, you add a small dab of the included NTH1 thermal paste to the center of the heat spreader. Now, instead of trying to line up the cooler with the CPU and then flipping it all over to be able to thread the screws, I did it the other way around. I set the cooler down on the table with the base facing up, then flipped the motherboard over and lined the mounting holes up with the threaded holes in the base of the L9i. This is a better way to do it, so you can go straight to threading the screws rather than needing to carefully hold everything together while you flip it over. With the cooler in place, you tighten down the screws into the L9i's mounting arms. I always try to tighten things evenly by tightening one screw partially and then moving to the next. That way you avoid putting too much strain on the motherboard with one screw cranked all the way down and the others barely threaded. Also, Noctua made the user-friendly choice of using thumb screws, so you can get them tightened most of the way by hand, and then the last bit of tightening can be done with a screwdriver. After that, just plug in the fan to your motherboard's CPU fan header and it's good to go. If you want to keep the fan cable really tidy, you can unscrew the fan from the heatsink and rotate it to where the cable stays nicely wrapped along the fan's chassis. With it installed that way, this is a very clean look. And the L9i is just barely taller than standard height RAM, so this will fit into extremely slim cases. All in all, this is one of the easiest installation processes of any aftermarket CPU cooler I've ever tested. Very nice work here, Noctua. But now let's get to the benchmarks. My test bench here is an Intel i3-8100 running on a Gigabyte B360M DS3H with 8GB of DDR4 2400 memory, all powered by a Seasonic Prime AirTouch 850W power supply. Low temperatures are taken with the CPU running Prime 95, and cooling results are reported as deltas, degrees above ambient temperature. I'll be comparing the L9i with Intel's stock cooler to give a reference for its performance. First, we'll look at the idle results. These are the noise levels and temperature deltas with no programs running and the fans at their minimum RPM. The L9i is essentially essentially inaudible due to its super low minimum speed, whereas the Intel cooler bottoms out at about 1100 RPM. Because of the higher minimum speed on the stock cooler, it does run slightly cooler, but idle temperature doesn't matter that much since the processor isn't producing that much heat to begin with in idle conditions. Now we'll look at the load results. These measurements are taken with Prime 95 running and the fans at full speed to show the cooler's upper limits. Here is where you can see the benefits of the L9i. Almost 5 degrees cooler under full load and about 2 decibels quieter than the stock cooler. But the noise level by itself doesn't paint the full picture. The L9i has a 92mm fan, whereas the stock cooler is 80mm. The L9i uses a proper SSO2 bearing, whereas the stock cooler is at best a rifle bearing. Because of the smaller fan size and lower quality bearing, the stock cooler's sound profile is much more irritating, higher pitched and grating. The L9i, on the other hand, emits an unobtrusive whir, even at full speed. In terms of sound, it's significantly less noticeable. Now my favorite graph, temperature versus noise. This is under load with the fan speed varied from 100% down to the minimum speed the cooler can run without thermal throttling the processor. This graph is laid out so you can easily compare the cooler's noise levels at a given temperature or temperature at a given noise level. It shows a more complete picture of noise and deltas than the load graph I showed previously, and as you can see here, across the range of fan speeds, the L9i is significantly quieter and cooler than Intel's. The biggest difference is at around a 43 degree delta, where the L9i is nearly 10 decibels quieter than the stock cooler, which is an absolutely massive improvement. Looking at it the other way, at any given noise level, the L9i is 5 to 7 degrees cooler than Intel's stock cooler. Noctua's offering here is actually better, and sometimes significantly better, completely across the board. Beyond the fantastic cooling and noise performance, the L9i is just high quality all around. Both the heatsink and fan feel solidly built, they provide enough thermal paste for multiple installations, and the install process is one of the easiest I have ever experienced. The L9i is really second only to Intel's stock push pins in terms of how quickly and easily you can mount it, but it has the added benefit of not sounding incredibly obnoxious at literally every fan speed. There's honestly not much I'd change on the L9i, it's a solid cooler all around. Now for what you're probably here wondering, should I get the L9i? Like with most things in life, it depends. If you're building a big ATX tower PC or a mid-sized micro ATX tower, no. In those cases, you'll be able to fit a much larger and therefore much more effective cooler. There's just no reason to use a low profile cooler in those situations. But if you're building in a cramped mini ITX case, ultra slim desktop PC, or something like a home theater PC, that's where the L9i really shines. It'll give you significantly better thermal performance and acoustics over Intel's stock cooler and take up even less height in the case. At only about $40, it's a very easy investment to make to drop noise levels and temperatures by a pretty significant margin. This is a seriously good choice for a low profile cooler, and if you want to pick one up, click the link in the description. Hit subscribe and click the bell icon to get notified of new videos as soon as they're up. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, hit subscribe, and I want to hear from you. Have you thought about building a mini ITX or low profile PC? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, I hope I helped, and I'll see you in the next video. It's showtime. A9X14? A9X14? What do they call this fan? My test bench is a Ryzen 3 1200 overclocked to... No, it's not. This is not my AM4 system. This is an Intel system. My test bench is a Ryzen... It's not a Ryzen. Let's try it again. Showtime. Weird.